unplayable. After that disastrous hook with the 5 hybrid and having to drop by the fence, I just played a worldie to get onto the green. That's a beaut, but a very tricky green to say the least. Just for the record, this is my 4th round here, and that's the first time I've ever been over bogey par, so I got a 7, but I'm feeling fine about things. It was just that hook, and then an impossible lie, and I had to have that drop, but that's the first time I've been over bogey par, but I'm feeling good about the round. Let's see how it pans out. That's how good I'm feeling, despite having got a 7. I'm just feeling really, really good, and that was one of the best drives I've done in a while. Absolutely perfect. Even went round the corner. So far. Thank you. The atmosphere now is absolutely divine. Cloudy weather, but obviously, you know, still 30 degrees. It's not sweltering. It just feels lovely. It's lovely not having bright sunshine in your eyes. And yeah, I mean, I haven't started brilliantly, but I've played some good shots already, and I sort of feel better about playing today than I have done on the other rounds, I think. Just enjoying the feeling of being here. Now this hole, if I could par it, would get me down to 79 on the eclectic round, because I've only ever got a six, or got sixes on the last two rounds. But this is just beautiful, it's like being in England. It really is, look at that. Just past the pin, off the green, and rolled back down. So I need a chipper. I knew it was going downhill, but not that much. It's actually gone all the way down there. This is ridiculous. Like it, but even that, look at that, couldn't have done it much slower. Of errors as the rain comes down after three nice shots onto the green. That putt, which just I just did not realize it was that bad. It doesn't look like it here, but I did it gently and it went so far off, it was ridiculous. Then I did a ridiculously thinned R55 and then a good little delicate one back, but even that went 13 feet over. And so I come out with a 9, which is classic hacker territory, so 4 over. This is not going to be a good round now, but I've still got that target of the eclectic round. My goodness, no, what a disaster. It just shows how well I've played on the other rounds to have not had those disasters. But it's really pouring now, so I might have to stop anyway for a while. Oh dear. Funnily enough, I'm really enjoying it. Cabby mentioned just now the possibility of a rain check, because it was looking really heavy just now, but it has cleared up, so I'm not going to be tempted, even though it's tempting to scrub this round after what just happened. But no, I must persevere. I might turn it into a bad round which had some good moments, and that's what it's going to be, because I must try and get that eclectic score down. Nearly hold it. So after thinning that last shot with the R55, then because I'm on an upslope, I find it so much easier, and I get that tap in par. That's helped things.
hut.
That was amazing. 20-foot putt. I remember saying on the first video I did here that I think I found my new favourite place in Thailand. And after that tee shot, it certainly wasn't. And then a chip up, which wasn't bad given that there were roots in the way. And then an absolutely divine 20-foot putt. That was nothing to do with luck with that one. So, second par in a row. That's my ball there, but unfortunately the rain's coming down again, so it's going to be a problem today. It's too wet to play right at this moment, so I'm going to have to wait again. But nice drive, a bit downhill, 230, so I'm very pleased with that. So we've had to come back to the little drinks hut. At the scene of where I had the 9 before the 2 pars and that wonderful drive. And we've had to mark the drive on the fairway and drive over here to try and keep dry because the rain is pretty heavy. It's easing off a bit now, but it's still too heavy to play in. So after a 20-minute break, we're back. Still raining, but okay to play. And here is where my ball was. one went from 10 feet to 6 past the pin, because I thought with my feet squelching the ball was going to stop. But I'm very proud of the fact that I stopped and waited for the cart to stop, because I then hold a very nice putt to keep a bit of momentum going, bogey putt. That time I utilised the natural hook in that club to go around the corner. Don't know what the lie will be like, but I've cut off about 60 yards compared to yesterday, I think, and the day before, so it could be good. So look at that, it's just come around the corner in front of the tree. Trouble is, no local knowledge there, because I didn't realise there was a tree bang in the middle of the fairway if you come down this side. So I've got to try and go around it. We'll go over it and nearly in the bunker. Not bad, though. That was sublime. Well, the beauty of that is I think that's the first time I've parred this, unless I did it in the first ever round. That means the eclectic score is down to 79, so I've achieved my aim for the day after the seventh hole. Thank goodness. Actually, rather disappointingly, I've already parred that hole, so I haven't achieved the goal yet, which is slightly annoying. So I've got to try and do it on another hole. good one. I've parred this one before as well, so if I hole it for a birdie, for my first ever birdie, then I get the 79. So that is the pure focus today. I tell you what, the atmosphere now is beautiful with everything wet. Oh gosh, it was a great shot. It's a shame I didn't get the birdie, but I got a par, and amazingly, I'm now, after eight holes, back down to evens after that horrendous mare. So I'm not doing too badly after all. I thought I'd never claw back, but I have now clawed the score back, and so if it doesn't rain anymore, you never know. Could do okay. Said hit it straight, it's gone straight. Was a perler, and this is one of the ones. A two putt from there, I get down to 79 and neglect it. so brilliant because now I have done the eclectic score down to 79. I'm one under bogey par on the ninth. Now I can really, really enjoy it now. I was enjoying it anyway, but it was just earlier on with all the rain and then that terrible hole. It felt terrible. But now, beautiful course. I like the wet conditions. It's not even wet, it's just nice and moist. I'm going to enjoy the rest of this. Wild, hit a tree of a branch. One dog side about. Sure, it must be in the bunker. Yeah. This is certainly a wild one. Was truly magical. A foot from the pin. God, I feel so delighted about that. What an up and down. Horrible bunkers, but at least the sand was soft. Not proper sand, but like sort of soft mud, and just cut under it. And brilliant. So pleased. amazing how far the ball rolls. Even going uphill, it was rolling. Just a bit short. I was actually really pleased with that because the way I struck it, it just came off the club so nicely. With that sort of hard rubber sound. And even though we're short the green, short is better than going over because there's a bunker. And also, if it's easier to chip up. Famous last words. But that's three just before the green. And at the moment, I'm two under, so I'm equaling my best ever score. So, which is the last two rounds. But after that mare of a hole earlier on, that's a nice position to be in. That's a beauty. Oh dear. First time I've ever gone three under bogey par at any stage in a round here. So yeah, very, very pleasing. Sounded a good reaction. Just remember this hole from before, so it's perfect for the hybrid if I connect well, because it gets a bit of a hook, goes around the corner, but it will still roll down a bank, but we'll see. Bad shot, but a bit tentative in case I went over, but it's actually come out off decent. Yeah, I could have easily sort of connected with that with a full shot. It was very difficult because it was 70 yards, which is normally my favourite one with a choke down sandwich. But in this case, going downhill, very difficult to work out. And so, yeah, I didn't choke on that one. I just played it a bit gently. But when you see where I am, it's not too bad. Especially as that's in two. My feet were not level. I think, I mean, that's partly a straining, but my feet weren't level. The thing is, that was the first bad shot in a while, and it was only bad because, well, terrible lie, and yeah. But now I've got an awful lie because the ball is way above my feet. Just not bold enough there with the aiming right, because it all looks so dangerous, and of course it goes well left because of the slope. But I just wasn't bold enough to play the correct shot. Mind you, at least I connected. I think there's a bunker there because I remember filming a dog guarding it before. No need to go up this raised green there, as I went over it. This time I've royally messed it up. going so well too. Oh, I thought I was in the bunker. Well, that's nice, I'm not. So I didn't hit it too hard after all. A bit hard, but not too bad. That's a bonus. Rubbish. Well, it's a five, could have been a lot worse, but unfortunately after dropping two shots on the last hole, I'm now down to only one under bogey par, which is a great pity. That was absolutely dire, but just kept rolling. Straight into the bush. Terrible shot. Thread it through. Might as well have a go.
bad shot.
I wasn't following the reseller advice there. I just decided to go for something that was far too risky and paid the price to hit trees and have now ended up on the tee box over here. So, a very, very silly error. I just fancied having a go. See where my ball is after what I thought was a perler. And the caddy was looking with me over there behind here, and I thought we'd seen it. And she said, oh, I thought you were looking for a baby bird. What a sight. I thought it was a good shot. It's just so awful when I do that. I mean, it's this thing of, it's a slight downward slope, and so you just can't get under the ball, and I could sort of see that, but I just didn't act on it. Another ridiculous shot. So this is just about this and the other hole, after doing so well to recover from that 9 earlier on, is absolutely messing things up now. That's 5 already. Absolutely brilliant. And down there over this large hump, so I couldn't even see the hole. And then you've got that slope to the left, so I had to avoid going that side.
bold enough.
So two holes to play. I'm still on evens. So there's still a possibility of keeping my record going of never going over 90 or 90 or over. But it's made tougher by not piring that. One positive though, whatever happens now, is that I think I've got my record number of pars on the course is 7. So I've had the mares today, but I've also had the pars. After a couple of bounces. It's disappointing that it's gone a long way over, so it was struck too hard therefore, but still, that was nice to see. That's the end of the bogey par dreams. Three putting from there. What a pity. So just waiting for a girl to play out front who was going off the white tees. She must be about 14. Looked pretty good. One over bogey par at the moment. I have to par this one to get down to bogey par. What is bogey par? 90. So, oh god, it's a bad score. Because even, yeah, so one over bogey par is 91, I think. Oh Christ. So anyway, I won't be going under 90 today. But I suppose the main thing is I kept going, even though it was pretty awful. And we were getting wet and having the rain delays. But overall, I'm in beautiful conditions, really, once the rain had gone. And not at all hot, lovely subdued weather. And the other key thing is, I did get 7 pars, which is great. And more good footage. And the other thing, of course, is that my eclectic round is definitely under 80. So I'm pretty sure it's 79. So that's the best thing. Thank you. Well, I had the right idea there to aim far to the right because the ball would come in, but just didn't hit it very well. So I'm well short of the green. But at least I hit it. So yeah, a bit disappointing today. But I think there are some memorable moments on the video. So I'll have to write it, chalk it down to that. Here comes my club. Yeah, so yeah, overall disappointing in terms of score and messing up on a few holes completely, but did play some holes really, really well, did some great shots. So yeah, and that eclectic score, that was the aim at the beginning of the day, it's in the bag. So not an absolutely ideal ending, but not a bad one to have a second putt as a tap in and a bogey par to finish. So that's a round of one over bogey par, 91. Worst round I've played here, but seeing as I had some mares, overall not too bad. Well, here's the thing to cheer me up about that round. I thought I had seven pars, but because of the mess that I've got in my book, because I filled in the wrong place a time before, so I was on a different page. It actually turns out that I've got eight pars today, so easily the record, whereas I think the record before was five. I'm not 100% sure, but I got eight. The train's just coming in. But this is the incredible detail, and I didn't even notice it. Seven. 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12 were all parred. So on this harder course, I got 6 pars in a row. And I didn't even know I'd done it. I just thought I'd got a few pars together. And, so even though I only got do the classic Thailand noise everywhere. That's the shoe cleaner in the background. So yes, for all the mares, I only got 4 bogey pars, 8 pars. So that was 6 holes where I dropped shots on. So no wonder I went above bogey par. But there's the memorable detail. 6 pars in a row. I'll have to work out now how many knocked a stroke off. So the nicest surprise of the day was that when I checked my notebook, I found that it wasn't 7 pars that I got, but I actually got 8 pars. Only 4 bogey pars, so I messed up on 6.
which is what explains why my score was so bad. But the incredible thing is, from the six in a row, and I'm pretty sure I've only ever got five pars before, so I actually got six in a row this time. So that is the best consecutive period I've played on this course. I know when I really messed up early on and looked like I was hitting with the rain and everything, all the disruptions, for one of the worst rounds ever. That was the worst round that I've had here, but even though it was the worst round, I was only the worst round by two, and the real positive is that I get eight pars, my record, and some great footage of it. And now it's back to the hotel, get changed, and then I'm going out for chicken tikka masala. Don't fancy doing any more practice. Good to be home.